Great. They're going to give a presentation of Harshvardhana, one of the North India's most celebrated heroes. Harshvardhana or Harsha, 590 to 647 AD, Uttar Pradesh was the Lord of North, was a gifted warrior, administrator, a generous patron, and a patron of religions and hearts. His family, Baba Kahavardhana, was the father of Harshvardhana, and Rajyavardhana was the elder brother of him, and Rajyastri was the sister for her. After the death of Prabhakaravardhana, Rajyavardhana became the king. He was yet murdered by the king of Kauda, Sasanga. Harshvardhana became the king. He was only 16 at that time. After the succession, he united the two kingdoms of Taneshwar and Kanauj and changed his capital from Taneshwar to Kanauj. He then defeated the king of Gauda, Sasanga. He was only able to bring the entire northern India under his control. The Narmada River was the southern limit for him. He won West Bengal, Bihar, Dhruva Sena and Punjab. Pulikesi to the Chalukya king of Vatapi stopped him at the banks of the Narmada River. Southern India was left untouched by him. His religion. Harshvardhana was at the beginning was a Shaiva follower, but then converted to the embraced on the Buddhism. It was believed that the Huang Sang converted him to the Mahayana Buddhism. He was open-minded and gave freedom to all his people to follow any religion. He prohibited animals' slaughter for food. He erected many stupas and constructed many travelers' stoves all over his kingdom. Kumbh Mela. He was credited as a patronizer of Kumbh Mela, which is the festival in the Triveni Sangamam, where two physical rivers of Ganga and Yamuna and one invisible river of Saraswati. During the king's time. It happens during every 5 years, but now happens only during 12 years. He gave all his personal earnings among the people, and with a single coat cloth, he left to the kingdom and started his kingdom again. The war military achievements of Harshvardhana. The war against the Pulikesi II. Both the emperors meet each other at the banks of the Narmada River again. 1634 AD. The war continued for 2 years, but both the emperor could not win the war. Finally, they came treaty, became good friends, returned their capitals, and returned back with the titles of Uttarapateshwar and Dakshinapeshwar, the Lord of North and the Lord of South. He then his army usually contained four traditional divisions: horse, chariot, elephant, and cavalry. The cavalry was more than 1 lakh, and the elephant was more than 60,000. He organized an assembly at Kanauj assembly, which means he invited all the representatives of the religion and made a grand assembly. Next, we can see Nalanda. Nalanda University is located at the modern Baragon, 65 km southwest of Patna in Bihar. It has more halls and buildings and storage where 8,500 students and 1,500 teachers live. It provided free lodging and food for the people. The name of entrance examination. It attracted not only the people from the other parts of India, but also from the other parts of the world. Next is the death of Harsha. Harsha was married to Durgavati. He had two sons, Bhagyavardhana and Kalyanavardhana. Both the sons was killed by Avinashwarya, chief minister in Harsha's court. He then left holy abode in 647 AD after ruling the entire India for more than 41 years. Since he left behind no heirs and no sons left, his kingdom was rapidly disintegrated and collapsed into states again. Next is the US. Around late 5th or early 6th century, establishing of Ashas Empire. 590 AD, Harshavardhana was born. 606 AD, Harshavardhana took the throne. 630 AD, Huang Sang visited the Harsha's court. 636 AD, the war against the Pulikesi II. 643 AD, a grand assembly at Karnoj for honoring the Huang Sang. 647 AD, the death of Harsha. Thank you.